Arepa and choclo.
We in Little Colombia right now. I'm copping Colombian football jerseys. Golazo!
This is Colombian Independence Day, so we do it big.
No, this is real Queens, not Dairy Queen.
I already can tell this is about to be a good episode.
What comes to mind when you think about the country of Colombia? It's probably something you saw on TV, and let's be honest, it probably was rated R. But what's shown in the media can be very different from the reality of everyday life. Today, we're going to find out about authentic guava hot dogs, soccer, and bandeja paisas with our friend Jay Shells in Jackson Heights, Queens, New York.
What's going on, everybody? Welcome to a special South American episode of Fun Grows Food. Today, we're here out in Jackson Heights, Queens, out here on Northern Boulevard, and we are going to be trying different types of authentic Colombian cuisine. And of course, we couldn't do it without a authentic Colombian friend, so we got Jay Shells.
What's going on, guys? My name is Jay Shells, first generation Colombian, born and raised in Queens, New York. And I'm going to show these fine gentlemen some amazing Colombian food.
So we are on Northern Boulevard. I see a ton of Colombian businesses. Can we call this Little Colombia?
We'll call it for today.
There's no official name.
There are a lot of Colombian flags out here.
We're a lot more than stereotypical narcos. There's more to Colombia than what you see on TV.
That's the media. It's the media.
Colombia itself as a country is so diverse in itself.
I mean, the top part of Colombia is a little bit more Caribbean. You have the more inland area. I mean, it's just so diverse, even as far as people and food and culture, right?
And language.
And language.
Hey, you guys, we are here to challenge some preconceived notions, both on the cuisine side, the culture side. I'm super excited.
Let's eat.
Jay Shells, let's go. All right, first off, we are leading off at La Perrada de Chalo.
So what is this spot?
So this is an appetizer. You know, we have quick food. It's 24 hours. This is usually where everybody comes, like after the clubs, after parties.
Okay.
It's not real sit and dine, just grab and go.
So is this something that you might eat in Colombia?
Nothing here is really your traditional type of plates. This is, like I said, very Americanized and catered to now, you know, the United States. For your traditional plates, la bandeja paisa, arepas, empanadas, buñuelos, you can get over at like a restaurant.
But we're going to get that later.
We're going to make our way there.
Yeah, let's check this out.
All right, you guys, we're in
La Perrada Chalo.
What is the story behind the Hawaiian hot dog?
So the Hawaiian hot dog is a mixture of different sauces and condiments all mounted on top of one. You're gonna see it when we order it right now. It's actually, I eat it with a fork and a knife. It's real messy. It tastes very, very different than your typical American hot dog.
So what we're about to eat is strictly Colombian American late night food.
Queens, New York.
Queens, New York.
Specifically Queens, Northern Boulevard food. All right, you guys, while we are waiting for our Colombian Hawaiian hot dogs, where are we at? Because we just gotta get something in our stomachs right now.
So I brought them over to the panaderia, Seba Seba, to get a couple small stuff like buñuelo, empanadas, arepas, chorizo, and maybe some special drinks.
Okay, so this is a Colombian bakery, Seba Seba. Let's check it out.
All right, you guys, we are in Seba Seba, Colombian bakery. My very first time in my entire life. I'm very excited right now. The thing that strikes me is how different it looks from, I'm from the West Coast. Most of the Latin bakeries that I've been in my life are Mexican.
You'll notice a very distinct taste. It can look the same, but like I said, different South American countries and Central America with Mexico. You're gonna notice a difference in how it's cooked, how it's made, how it's served. You know, it definitely gives you a real taste for the culture.
What other cuisine, I guess, that other people might be familiar with, would you say Colombian is close to? Is it close to Cuban food? Is it close to Peruvian food?
Because I personally eat Dominican, Puerto Rican food, and I eat a lot of Cuban food, and they're all very, very different.
Arepa and choclo.
Wow.
Yeah, that was good.
How good is it?
Super fluffy. I like this one even more than the arepa.
Really? I hope the engine doesn't kill me for this, but we make the best empanadas. You guys are foodies, so give me your honest opinion.
I know empanadas is a big thing amongst the Latin American countries because everybody got their own.
The best empanadas.
This is the almohada.
That's the pan de yuca. Really dry.
Hey, it's like a mochi. It's like a cheese mochi.
Yes, yes.
That might be my favorite.
Almohada?
Yeah, this is
cheesy, right?
Yeah. You guys, Seba Seba, Colombian bakery. I determined that my favorite was the almohada.
Almohada?
Yeah.
This buñuelo, you just stick it in your hand almost like a baseball, and you just...
Did you try the empanada? You said you like Dominican ones the best.
All right, do you stand by Seba Seba that they're going to deliver a good...
100%.
This is a good empanada, not just like a run-of-the-mill.
I throw them in the ring.
So usually I like the fluffier fried ones that are flour, but this one being corn and it has a thin, very crispy, hard corn crust, that one was really good. This was good. All right, guys, yo, that was a great warm-up at Seba Seba. I'm ready to go get the hot dogs.
All right, you guys, while we are crossing the street, and we're gonna check out some Colombian soccer jerseys. I'm drinking the Lula.
Hugo Lulo.
I'm Hugo the Lula.
Mira, cuando tú bailas, tiembla toda la tierra.
All right, you guys, we are in La Perchado.
La Parada de Chalo. I will say this, at every Colombian restaurant that I've been to, and maybe I didn't go to the most authentic ones, they usually do have at least the Americanized Colombian hot dog. So maybe this is like having kind of like your orange chicken or General Tso's at your Chinese spot. A lot of authentic Chinese restaurants will still serve those dishes just because it's what everybody knows.
Well, they're popular, right? Traditionally in America, they're popular.
Yeah.
Hawaiian hot dog. You see this? You can see the cheese on top. You see the crushed chips.
You don't even know where to begin.
You see the mayo. Oh man, I can only take one bite, guys, because I know we got a lot of food to go. Yo, one thing I really liked about that hot dog, it was really smooth, creamy, and had the sweetness because of that guava jam or whatever it is. That was like spicy, sweet, creamy on a hot dog with some cheese. That was good. All right.
You're the one with the egg, man.
So how is this different?
Your brother didn't. Yeah,
how is this different?
It has the egg. It doesn't have the guava sauce.
No guava sauce.
Okay, so the
guava sauce, that's what makes it really different because that is super un-Western. Like Americans would not put guava on a hot dog.
I don't know, I think I might like that one better.
Really?
There was still got a little guava underneath the egg.
Yeah, there was still some guava. Okay. Yo, hey, you guys, just get both if you come here. All right, Jay, our next spot on this Colombian food crawl, we're about to get dessert.
I brought them over to El Palacio de los Cholaos. A little bit of sweet after everything they just ate was a little salty, fried, mixture of a lot of everything. This is gonna be the little cherry on top.
I've never had a chelado before, so I'm super excited. You said that these are heavy, right?
Yes, they are. They're extremely heavy. It's a mixture of fruits and condensed milk.
Let's check it out, El Palacio.
Jay, paint me a picture, man. We got the chelada.
Summer in Queens, growing up. This is refreshing. This is after the park, after the pool, after being at Flushing Meadow Park for a couple hours.
So instead of the Dairy Queen,
That doesn't exist.
Right.
That doesn't exist, man. You come here, you get one of these.
No, this is real Queens, not Dairy Queen. All right, so I can see a lot of condensed milk. I see a lot of strawberries. David, go ahead
Banana.
And grab.
Oh, I'm
is there like a
this.
Cherry?
There's I'm like a slushy portion cherry. To this down at the bottom.
Yes, it's iced.
Awesome. Iced, all right.
Crushed ice.
Gelato.
I'm a big fan of condensed milk. You know, growing up, Hong Kong, also, they consume a lot of condensed milk.
Do they really?
Yeah. No shade, but the chelados might also give you diabetes.
Yes, I do recommend once a month, not a daily thing. Oh, he's going in. He's going in for a brain freeze.
Man, that's really good.
Right? It's
so guilty. It's exactly what you think it is. Condensed milk, strawberry, slushy.
For a hot day like this.
Oh, man. Shout out to the cholada. I don't know if I can finish the rest, though.
All right, you guys, we are in Little Colombia for today, and I'm seeing groups of Colombians walk by, and they actually all look super different from each other.
Colombians come in all shapes and sizes and forms. I, believe it or not, I get Asian a lot.
Okay, I can see half Filipino for sure.
I get that. Yeah, but you're Colombian and Asian mix. I'm like, no, I'm Colombian 100%.
All right, well, where are we in front of right now? Because we've been having a lot of snacks and
tried
bakeries.
Snacks, appetizers, dessert.
But we haven't had like traditional restaurant meals yet.
We're going in for the main course right now. We're going in for bandeja paisa.
That is the national dish of Colombia, correct?
Fishing, yes.
I heard it's because everybody's got to get up and work hard, so it's designed to give you a lot of protein and energy.
It's definitely a carb load. You're going to get a lot of energy. It's definitely a big plate for one person, but keep in mind it is for one person.
We'll probably be splitting it up and getting some other stuff as well, so let's check it out. Los Toldos.
Wow,
you guys are aware that today is Independence of Colombia, right?
Oh, is that... You didn't know that?
So today is the Colombian Independence Day.
Yes, July 20th.
Perfect.
All right, forgive my ignorance. Independence from who?
Oh, man, you got me stumped there.
You threw me under the bus there.
This is agua panela. This is a childhood memory. You know every Colombian household has this.
This is a
in
brown
fridge.
Brown sugar.
Yes.
Brown sugar agua.
The flavor is just sugar cane. There's no other flavor other than sugar cane.
It's like nice tea, if you want to call it that.
Go for it. And this is the guava one.
Yes, in milk.
I never had anything like that before.
Guayaba.
I don't know what fruit that's from. That is very refreshing.
I like this. It's a little tangy, sweet, slightly has like some tamarind flavoring to it.
Your average household iced tea.
Yo, this
is good.
This guava milkshake is pretty
good. All right, you guys, round one has arrived here at Los Toldos. This is a very traditional Colombian restaurant. If you have one in your city that is authentic, it's probably serving this.
Bandeja paisa, also known as bandeja montañera, sopita, and una picada.
All right, so this is the national dish of Colombia.
Yes, this is a very typical Colombian dish.
And you told me that different places have a different name for this, correct?
Yeah, they call it either bandeja montañera, bandeja típica, or bandeja paisa.
So this is designed to give you energy in the morning to go and do some hard labor.
Wait, and this is meant for one person?
This is a one
what
person.
What kind of labor are they doing?
Bandeja paisa.
We in Colombia, guys.
I gotta get that really chicharrón, like, it's delicious.
I feel like the flavors are keeping it so simple, but so good.
This is a great bite right here. I have arepa, I have rice, I have the medoros, I have the chicharrón.
Tell us about this mixed plate.
This is just a mixture of meats. You have carne asada, chicharron, yuca. You also have chorizo, which is a sausage. Carne asada, the plantains. So you mentioned earlier, right, the difference in the spices. Uh-huh. Not as spicy, but just as flavorful.
Yeah.
Andrew's playing his mother.
Yeah.
He's putting together good bites.
Yeah, we will call Andrew the mixologist.
Yeah, he's putting it together right.
You guys here, I got some beef, got some carrots. It looks like maybe some cucumbers or not cucumbers.
No, cilantro.
Cilantro, okay, I'm excited to try this. I'm a big soup guy.
This almost reminds me of the Vietnamese bon khao. So it's like this really thick kind of beef curry stew, and that's from the Vietnamese, obviously with some French influence, but this just is like that thick beef stew that just, it works in every culture, man.
Even on a hot day, it's good.
Yo, I don't even get if it's 100 degrees, right? Somebody's gotta be drinking that sopita.
You like
it.
You said you're a soup guy.
I'm a soup guy.
How do you guys feel about the fried egg on top?
Oh, the fried egg was crucial. The fried egg was crucial, man.
The reason I asked that is because a lot of people get thrown off by it. A lot of my friends in California who have never tried Colombian food always feel a little uneasy or questionable, like what's up with the fried egg? And I'm glad you said that, because without it, it just doesn't give you the same flavor. It doesn't give the same impact, right? It doesn't deliver that taste.
Can I tell you something though? Actually, the most underrated item of this whole meal, I say the beans.
Really?
The beans are delicious. These are some of the best beans I've ever had. I mean, look at the flavor. I could see the flavor in those beans, man. How it's yellow, it has like that, I don't even know what type of powder is in it, but it's got all this fat and oil.
So you asked me earlier, right, the difference between the Puerto Rican, Dominican, and Colombian, right? Mm-hmm. The beans. You said you have Cuban food, right?
Mm-hmm.
You notice they use black beans? We use red kidney beans. Mexicans use refried beans.
All right.
Sometimes the devil's in the details, the difference is in the beans.
All right, you guys, we just finished our traditional restaurant meal at Los Toldos. We are starting to wrap it up, but we still got one portion left, right, Jay? Where are we going?
We're going to La Arepa Lady on 37.
So this is not actually the only like little Columbia street, right?
No, not at all. This is definitely one of my favorites, one of my childhood memories as far as hanging out, eating, culture, everything.
Really. So we're headed to another street. We're going to talk about culture, media representation, stereotypes all over some traditional Colombian and non-traditional arepas.
If we go further down that way, right, you're going to hit more Indian. Go further down that way, you'll hit way more Dominican.
Dude,
when you hit Junction.
Honestly, Queens is like a gigantic international terminal for like Delta.
It's a Color of Benetton's commercial.
Dude, it really is United Colors of Benetton commercial.
We just walked four blocks.
Four blocks, and look how different it is for you guys.
Every time I come to Queens, man, it blows my mind. We were on Northern Boulevard, now we're on 37th. What's different? Immediately, I'm noticing a lot more different South American countries.
Yes.
More Mexican restaurants. People look different.
More commercial. We're also two blocks away from the 7 train. Anyone who's ever ridden the 7 train knows how diverse the 7 train takes.
Famous for diversity.
Well, 100%. You know that you have to take the 7 train, first of all. It's a free tour guide from Shea Stadium, right?
You know what?
All the way to Manhattan.
Everybody that is super racist in America should be forced to take the 7 train.
100%. Holy. That is the best way to put it.
Let's solve racism with the 7
with
train.
With the 7 train. That's it.
I love that quote.
Actually love that. That's a great analogy.
So we're going to check out the Arepa Lady, which is Colombian, but I'm seeing Uruguay spots, Peruvian spots, Italian spots, this spot, that spot, Mexican spots.
All right, so we're on our way to the Arepa Lady, but David, you're going to make a stop. You're going to go to Pollos a la Brasa.
Heard this is the Colombian answer to Peruvian chicken.
Yes, you had mentioned earlier Peruvian chicken is something you specifically like, right?
I got to put you on the spot, Jay. You taking this over Pio Pio?
Yes, 100%, I will. I stick with it. I stick with it.
Okay.
But to defend myself, I normally go to the one on 84th and Roosevelt, for those who are not native to Queens.
Okay.
I was totally caught off guard by how lively this street was. There's a Colombian cafe right behind us.
I'm glad you saw that.
What is this, Cafe de Colombia?
Yes, actually.
Why don't you guys pop in here, get something? I'll meet you guys at the Arepa Lady. Right, I'm going iPhone, guys.
What is this? An arepa spot. It is something homemade. The owner, she had been selling arepas for more than like 30 years on the street. She came from Colombia a very long time, brought her kids at a very young age. Some of her sons, they actually took over the business, but they wanted to make it, you know, something for families, because it's more like a family thing. But they're really good, and they've made a really good name for themselves. They've been in a lot of places.
All right, you guys, we are at round 5, Cinco.
Final stage, ultimate boss.
You guys, we're at Arepa Lady, where it's the kids, they sort of like took what their mom was doing that was so popular, right? And they wanted to sort of like, what, modernize it?
Make it more pop culture-y.
More accessible to just what, the New York generation, right?
Yes.
So here we have a mixture. So these are from the Arepa Lady, and then we also have the Pollo a la Brasa, and then we have some more different style of bakery items.
Andrew, just say what you said off camera.
All right, listen, man.
What did you say off camera?
I saw Jay Balvin. In a video with munchies.
Split it with me. Take half.
Amazing.
Oh, Game over.
All right, so I have to eat these because Jay ate them.
Chicharrón de Arequipe. Say it with me.
Chicharrón Arequipe.
Real quick, I'm going to go into the pollo a la brasa. You know, sort of like we have a Colombian take on elotes here. We got a Colombian take on Peruvian chicken. I'm going in.
I want to hear this feedback.
The Peruvian one is gonna be a little bit more like herbaceous, I think, a little bit more saltiness on the outside, but I will say this green sauce wins. I like this one.
So a lot of my friends love the green sauce, especially in California when I've introduced it to them.
This is like creamy oil right
Not
here.
As spicy.
Because you lived in San Diego for a while because you were in the military, right?
Yeah, I still live in San Diego.
So you have a lot of experience being like a Colombian ambassador to a lot of people who have never been exposed to.
Introducing a lot of my friends to Colombian food.
And one of the jobs of being a Colombian ambassador is to tackle Colombian stereotypes.
Yes.
Real quick, man. Let's address the elephant in the room in terms of cultural stereotypes. Is Colombia at all like Narcos?
No, not at all. Not in modern day.
Where does it come from? There's so much stuff in Narcos about Pablo Escobar, and that's sort of like what is top of mind, right, when people think of Colombia?
Unfortunately, yes. It really sidetracks so much other cool things that Colombia has. Like I said, I mentioned earlier, race car drivers, famous painters, famous musicians, artists. There's so much more to Colombia than anything having to do with Narcos.
It is true that obviously in America, as international it is, we are just kind of subject to the larger media narratives, right?
Hollywood, right? I'm pretty sure, you know, being Asian, same things follow.
People used to always ask me if I know Kung Fu. Now people ask me if I'm with the CCP.
So that's the best thing about being Colombian and also being Colombian in Queens. You have your diversity of friends and what we do and what we represent, right? We have people like J Balvin and Maluma and Shakira who are musicians, right? And influencers in the fashion world and the creative world. Then you have race car drivers, F1 race car drivers, right? So it's a huge buffet style of people. So as far as the whole Narcos narrative, no, I couldn't tell you anything about that. I don't even know.
So let's go through some stereotypes. Colombians really love to drink coffee all the time.
Yes. Also, that's one of our number one exports.
The women are all beautiful.
100%. Proof is in the pudding, right? You just gotta look at the pictures.
All Colombians are party animals.
Yes.
Okay. Jay, you gotta have some of this.
Yo, we gotta get the shrimp burger, bro.
Colombian shrimp burger.
No, it sabor.
It has the red sauce in there, just like
that sauce.
Potato chips already in the burger as well.
I don't know, one thing I love about Colombian food is the use of that guava jam.
All right, you guys, we're looking at arepa queso and a arepa chocla.
Wow, this arepa is very thick, very dense.
This is really good.
I love the mixture of the sweetness, man.
You said your mom has this for breakfast every day?
Every morning, minus the chorizo. My mom starts her day off, unfortunately, like you said, stirs up a coffee. My mom will not start her day without a coffee. Monday, the day doesn't exist. We'll have to restart it if there's no coffee.
So is that a pretty like stereotypical breakfast
or typical breakfast
where it's like arepa and coffee?
The very last thing we are having today, Andrew, bust out the elotes and this arepa de choclo. Corn arepa right here, a different format than the other one, made differently, right?
Yes.
Arepa de choclo. Yo, this is really good.
What's that, bro?
This is crazy. This one
is better, sweeter, huh?
This one is crazy.
That arepa sweeter on this one.
Yeah. I'm sorry to anybody else out there, but the Colombian chicharrón is the best one I've ever had.
Okay.
I don't know exactly how you guys make it differently, but every chicharrón that I've had today, which I've had like four different ones, has been on point.
I can tell you the secret. It's Colombian.
Last but not least, they have a different word for this. What do they call this?
Mazorca. He said it had like a chipotle sauce. Okay. So I'm assuming this is gonna have like a spice kick to it.
Yeah, this is the very last thing that we're having on this crazy Colombian food.
You gotta try this one.
Jay,
you gotta go. Because
man,
this is the Colombian version.
I gotta go to the gym right after this.
This is the Colombian version of a Mexican dish. Come on.
All right, you want my honest feedback?
Mexican one's better?
Yeah.
All right, hey. That's okay. That's okay to say.
Yeah, Mexican one is way better.
All right, my personal favorite from Arepa Lady, Arepa de Choclo with the chicharrón.
I agree with you. Honestly, that was
really?
That was my favorite thing I had today.
Was it the fact that it's sweet?
So good.
Yeah, I just don't know, understand. I think it was the combination of the two different types of cheeses, the crema, the chicharrón, and the corn thin arepa.
Okay.
It was just something magical about that. I liked a lot of the stuff we had today. I love the bandeja paisa. I actually really like this jersey that I got.
Today you're an official Colombian.
Yeah, Chino de Colombia.
Chino Latino.
Chino Latino. All right, you guys. That is it for our crazy Colombian food crawl and culture crawl through Jackson Heights, Queens.
Hallo bien.
Hallo bien.
Oh man, we had so many good things, so much stuff that I had never had before. What do you want people to take away from this video?
Colombian culture is way more than what you see in Hollywood, way more than what you see in social media, way more than J Balvin. They have artists, painters, musicians, tons of creative different mediums. Also, one of the best foods, right guys?
Yeah.
It's good, it's good.
It definitely was different from what I've been exposed to in the media. And I knew that, but I didn't know it until I went and saw it. And I have to say that I've really enjoyed my time on Northern Boulevard and 37. Hey, but you know what, man? That wraps up our video, but we do have a real quick chat about Queens in general, man. We just gotta have a Queens chat.
Yo, we're knock. Bringing the other
what
Queens
up, bro?
Connect.
Knock.
What's going on, guys? My boy's right here, bro. This is Jackson Heights.
Real quick, what are you guys' ethnicities?
I'm Dominican and Colombian.
I'm from Bangladesh.
I'm from Nepal.
Hey,
that's
man.
Jackson Heights right here, bro. If you wanna see Jackson Heights, fine, bro. This is
right here. You guys have a rap group together? Y'all have a rap group?
Today is Eid. It's a big holiday for Muslims, right? My boy's about to go to my Bengali boy's house, right? To eat, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's just how it is, bro. It's family. We all eat each other's food. We grow up around each other's culture. Like, that's the beauty of Queens, you know what I'm saying? It's so much overlap. Like, even, like, growing up here, like, you know, whether it's Bengali food, Nepalese food, Tibetan food, right? Or like you want to walk over to Woodside's, like right there, you know what I'm saying? Get the Filipino food.
I've never separated the difference between my Asian friend, my African American friend, my Colombian, Dominican, Puerto Rican. We all just one melting pot. It was just normal. This is a perfect example. Yeah. He called it. He said it right here, straight up. This is Queens.
Do all Queens dudes dress the same? I mean,
wait.
He's saying we all dress the same. Yeah, we all fly, right?
We all good looking dudes. All right, you guys, man. I highly recommend if you guys are ever in New York City, make sure you section out a little chunk of time. Come check out Queens, man, especially Jackson Heights.
Thank you so much for watching that video, everybody. Big shout out to Jay. Big shout out to Knock. Shout out to these guys right here. This is Queens right here, but this was our Colombian episode, man.
Yo,
thank you so
thank
much
you for, having
for taking
me.
Us through.
I
hope it was
it.
Very Yo, helpful and educational to the people out there. Like we said, come out here. Queens has everything.
Queens get the money.
In the comments down below, let us know like what other areas or pockets of neighborhoods that we should check out. And let us know if you have a favorite Colombian dish. And until next time, everybody, we out.
Peace.
All right, everybody, thank you so much for watching that video. We are back at Jay's store in the LES on Orchard Street headquarters. Tell us something about this store because it's a pin store.
That's we have a little bit of apparel. We're 100% a pin accessory fashion brand. There's a pin for everybody on our wall, from nostalgic stuff to sneakers to cars to little fashion pieces and to memes and jokes.
Yeah, it almost, I mean, I would call it, you know, I'm not saying you got to call it that, a streetwear pin store.
High quality pins and t-shirts here at headquarters, Orchard Street, New York City.